Hi, good day, folks. This is Cheerful. I wanted to let you know that my cheerful giver of the day is Emma Didlake.
Welcome back to the Happy Times Cavalcade.
Happy, happy
Hey
joy,
now.
Joy. Happy, happy joy,
Woo-hoo!
Joy.
This is a good story. She's 110 years young, and today she'll meet President Barack Obama.
Oh, that's cool.
Fox News Rip Raj is in Waterford with a story of a real American hero.
Yeah, good morning, everybody. You know, every once in a while you get to cover a story that just stands out, and it will for the rest of my career. You meet amazing people, and this woman, Emma Didlake, 110 years old, and she's on her way to meet the president. Take a look. She's on this plane behind me, and she's heading to Washington. It's a short trip, all of 12 hours, travel time and all, but she will be in the Oval Office where she will be meeting the president. Now, President Obama is the one who requested a meeting with Ms. Didlake, and the reason is because, as you mentioned, she is the nation's oldest living veteran, 110 years old. She joined when she was 38 years old because she thought it would be something interesting to do. Her secret to living a long life, you know, she says she doesn't just have one secret, but she does eat her fruits and vegetables, but she also likes Cheetos also, so there is room for junk food, I guess. But in the meantime, today is not all about that. It's a different food for thought. It's about this real interesting opportunity for both parties, for President Obama and for Ms. Didlake, to meet one another. They both say it's an honor for different reasons.
Do you think that we respect them enough, or should we be doing more for the veterans?
Well, since they will be required to do more, I think they should be given more.
And Emma Didlake will be coming back right here to Waterford, to Oakland International Airport. Her flight lands at 8 p.m. There's going to be a lot of military valor and honor that's going to be involved with her arrival back here. They're going to have a tribute to Miss Emma Didlake, the nation's oldest veteran, right here from Metro Detroit in West Bloomfield. So we continue to follow her story throughout the day. Look for that online and on TV.
Well, Emma, thanks for being a cheerful giver. I hope you had a wonderful day with the president yesterday. Be kind always.